And so with mindful walking, the principal encouragement is to continue sensing into the bottoms of the feet as they touch the ground. Walking between 20 to 25 steps in one direction, mindfully turning around, walking the other way. So kind of pacing back and forth, sensing into the bottoms of the feet as we walk. There's different layers of experience we can sense into over time, like the bending of the ankles and the knees. Sounds the feet touching the ground, sounds of nature around us, sort of an embodied, fully embodied experience of walking. But you can't really go wrong with keeping it simple. Sensing just into the bottoms of the feet with each step. Heel, arch, toes. Heel, arch, toes. Heel, arch, toes. The late Thich Nhat Hanh would often encourage sort of kissing the ground with our feet. So imbuing each step with a sense of kindness for the earth. Other people will encourage a sense of receiving support from the earth and really sensing into the support from the earth. But my encouragement is to at least just sense into the physical sensations of the pressure of the bottoms of the feet as they touch the ground. Walking a little bit slower than normal, or a lot slower than normal if you wish. This isn't about getting anywhere. This isn't about reaching a destination. This isn't about an outcome. This is about sensing into each step. For those of you who prefer not to walk or feel like you're not in a space where you can walk, even four steps back and forth, then we can practice mindful standing. I can guide you through some things to consider while we stand. But for those of you who I invite you to stand. And bend the knees and sense into the ground. Sometimes I'll jump, really kind of feel into the weight of the body on the bottoms of the feet. And begin to notice, how are we balanced? Are we kind of leaning forward or backward? Are we leaning towards one foot or the other? It's most of our weight on the insides of the feet to the outsides of the feet. Where is most of the pressure on the bottoms of the feet? Sometimes I'll lift up all of my toes to see what that's like. Sensing into the bottoms of the bones and the tissues and the skin. Sensing into bottoms of the feet as we stand. Are the feet splayed? Just noticing. Are you bringing your feet closer together? Noticing what that feels like. Your feet further apart. And then leaning towards the left side and sensing into more weight on the left foot. Where is that pressure? And then leaning to the right side, feeling the bottom of the right foot. Leaning back onto the left foot, sensing into the right foot as we're on the left foot. Leaning towards the right foot, but sensing into the left foot. Coming back to center. Sensing into both feet. Leaning forward, sensing into the toes. Backwards, sensing into the heels. Back to center. Now in a safe way, maybe leaning towards the left foot and raising the right foot up a little bit. Coming back down. Leaning to the right foot, lifting the left foot briefly. Coming back to center. So continually noticing the bottoms of the feet as we move. And even when we're at center, even when we're feeling balanced, can we notice these micro movements of ourselves continually balancing ourselves upright? And we're never really very still for very long. Even without choosing to stay upright, per se, we're still continually rebalancing ourselves, He's nuanced. Movements around the ankles, the knees, pelvis, our core. So we're continually rebalancing ourselves, even if we feel balanced. It's kind of like riding a bike, continually shifting little movements to stay upright. Noticing the muscles of the feet, the ankles. All these little micro adjustments as we stand. And as we stand, maybe noticing whether we're twisted in a certain direction. If we're hunched over a little bit. If our hips are kind of tilted up or tilted down. Are there certain muscles are unnecessarily contracted? Whether our knees feel locked, whether our shoulders feel balanced. The general invitation is just to have your hands and arms just kind of drop by the sides loosely. Although there's nothing wrong with holding them together. Is our chin up or down? So, how do we hold ourselves when we stand? Can we allow our belly to soften as we breathe? This can be a incognito practice, meditation that we can do in the shower, or as we're cooking. So we're standing in line. We're standing anywhere. Can we invite this embodied presence? Throughout the body. Awakening to the energy in every part of the body as we stand. This energy of being awake throughout the body. Perhaps experimenting, moving the arms around, the hands and the fingers from this fully embodied, awakened state. Feeling the body as we move. Remembering to breathe. Perhaps twisting the hips, bending the knees, the neck. Explore movement. The energy being awake in the body. As we move. Sensing into the bottoms of the feet as we move. Rooted in the ground. Our pliable limbs and core. Just being present for the energies of the body, this embodied state. Aware of the whole body. including the head. The heart. And the belly. And the bottoms of the feet. Maybe taking a couple of deep breaths. For those of you who wish to practice mindful walking, please, you know, find a safe space between, say, 4 to 25 steps in one direction. And then when you reach the end, sensing in the bottoms of the feet and noticing which direction you turn backward, which foot you pick up first, sensing into the shifts of the body, the bottoms of each foot as you twist. Noticing which foot you start pacing with. Sensing into heel, arch, toes. Heel, arch, toes. Heel, arch, toes. Heel, arch, toe. Continually sensing into the bottom of each foot. And for those of you who prefer to stand or even sit and experimenting with sensing into the body, as you explore these movements of the body, this energy of being awake throughout the body as we move. And as we're exploring this, if there's anyone who has any questions, please feel free to ask. Any concerns? Heel, arch, toes, heel, arch, toes, this energy of being awake in the body. As we move, it's not about doing or getting. It's about being. Being embodied. Even as we move. Wherever we go. Here we are. Noticing how the sensations of the bottoms of the feet are changing. Sensations in different parts of the body are changing. We stay awake to these changing sensations. breathing naturally. With a soft belly. Now, maybe resting wherever you are. Finding a sense of balance, uprightness. This embodied presence. From the feet to the head, the arms, noticing what's coming up. Acknowledgement of what's here. Maybe taking a couple of deep breaths.